External Communications Coordinator for Ikeja Electric. She's making a return this week as well. Nice to have you in the building. Good morning.
Good morning, Victor. How are you today?
Very good. How was your weekend?
Very well. Hope you had a restful one too.
I did. So let's talk about Ikeja Electric. 7 days gone by. How are things faring with the disco?
Not bad. I guess there are a lot of positive feedback in the last, say, 1 week, except for some areas around Wednesday, Thursday. Otherwise, things are looking good in most part of the areas under the Ikeja Electric network.
So for those who do not know the net where you have, the network, where it covers now, can you just run us through what are those areas that Ikeja Electric covers?
So we have Shomolu Business Unit, Shomolu Business Unit, and that's from Arikpo to around the close to Abule Oja area in Igbobi. We also have...
I need to get that. So Shomolu covers, from Arikpo?
Yes.
You mean it?
Yes.
I was thinking that was supposed to be Ikeja.
No. That's
under Shomolu.
Yes, under Shomolu.
That's
But then it's divided into six business units. I think I should just take it off from there. So we have the Shomolu business area. We have the Korodu. We have Abule Egba. We have Akunwojo. And then we have Oshodi business units. So those are the areas under our network.
So areas like Ojo now, does it fall under the Ikeja?
Ojo, no, that's under
Eco
Disco. So of course we always would share boundaries. So like some areas in Mushi, you have the other side of the express under Eco, while on the other side, on this side, is our side on Ikeja Electric.
It's a very, very big distribution company, so to say.
Yeah.
So you guys cover a whole lot of places. Ikurudu, K2, right?
Yes, K2 is under the Shomolu Business Unit. Yes, and then you have
Abule Egba.
Yes, Odikponle, Egbeda, Ikpaja.
What are areas like Akute? Are they still under you too?
Yes, some part of Akute, yes.
Okay. All right. So I know that we've been trying to enlighten people. And one of the things that you guys have been trying to encourage is how people can be, self-sustaining. They can do things independently. Mm-hmm. Let's dwell a bit on that. How customers can, make use of technology to improve the service.
Yes. Okay, so essentially there are different ways. Say for instance, last week someone sent me a message asking me that he wants to know the balance on the outstanding from the money he has been paying.
I have that message here too. Okay. Somebody sent that last week and he said he's been paying 9,000 even though there was a debt on the prepaid meter since 2022 and he's been paying 9,000. But now he's always going to the office to search for the balance. Is there no way he can identify that himself?
Yes, he can, and he doesn't have to go to the office. We have an application, a web application called the single view. Yes, and just like the name implies, at a single view you're able to view everything concerning your prepaid or postpaid account, as the case may be. So the first thing that you need to do is to go to our website, or you can just type www.ikejaelectric.com/single view.
Okay,
that's the web address. But
www.ikejaelectric.com/single view. Okay.
Yeah. But then again, I don't expect people to memorize all of these things. So what you just need to do is to just go to Google, type the name Ikeja Electric, and add single view in front, then it takes you there. And so you're able to sign up. So just like the way your bank app works, with your bank app, you sign up, you put in your name, you put in all of the details required to set it up as a new user. So and then once you log in, if you're a prepaid customer, it allows you to impute your prepaid meter number.
Right.
If you're a postpaid customer, it also allows you to put in your postpaid, what we call CIS account number. Once you do that, you're able to view a lot of things. So in this instance, let's say you have been paying an outstanding, haven't gotten a meter, you can now go to that app to see how much you have paid, how much you have left, and even to see if all of the payments you have been making have been reflecting. So this is just one out of the things you could do.
Okay.
And then if you had previously lodged a complaint, we've been emphasizing SR, that service request number, service request number, you're able to click on that service request number to see what the update is. So you're able to tell, okay, they have done this, they have not done that, okay, is it with this person? So I give an example. Somebody says that they have come to retrieve a meter from his house, and then he has been waiting to get a feedback as to when the meter will be will be returned, and to even know if if his meter is covered under the warranty, on whether it is the responsibility of the disco. All of these things is you can just view it if you are signed up onto the Single View app. That's just one of the ways. And also, if you desire to just send an email, so you impute your account number, put all of the details that is required, you put it in the email and send it to customercare@ikejaelectric.com.
Right.
customercare@ikejaelectric.com.
Okay, let's look at some probable scenarios, because if you have a situation whereby the meter is bad and then we report this to any of your officials, they come around, they pick up the meter. Am I not supposed to get an update on what's going on with this meter?
Oh, yes. So at the point of before the meter, before they even come, before they visit your house, it means that you have reported that your meter is faulty, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that means an SR has been generated for you. So these are one of the ways through which you can find out what the status of that service request number is. So, for instance, you can either send an email with the one you already have to say, okay, what's the update on this? My meter was retrieved on this date, and here's the SR. Could you please give me an update by sending an email to customercare@ikejaelectric.com? You can also, haven't signed up, I believe, if you try the Single View web app, you'll be able to view what the status is. So all of this can be done from the comfort of your home. You don't have to go to the office.
And I'll get a reply, a response?
You would see, not a reply. You would, okay, so for email, yes, you get a response. For Single View, you will see it yourself. You'll be able to click on it and read whatever it is that is there. So it's like you have done something, there's a transaction on your bank app, and you go back there to click on transaction history. You're able to see the name of the person that the money was sent to, account number, time that it was sent, the date that it was sent. All of that information will be there. So that's the same way it applies to if you're using the Single View web app.
Right.
Sign up and you're able to see everything.
Right.
And we also encourage people to use on X, instead of dropping your message on at Ikeja Electric, we have the customer care X handle, which is dedicated solely to collating complaints. Yes.
Okay. What's that?
And that's at IE Serve on X. IE Serve. Once you just go to your X, formerly known as Twitter, and you click on IE Serve, you can go there and DM that account with your complaint, and then of course it will be sent to the appropriate unit. And what we always advise customers to do is to ensure that they put in all the details that we will need.
Okay.
Yes, put in all of the details that we need. So, for instance, you have to put in your phone number. You have to put in your meter number where you have a meter number. You also have to put in your CIS number if you're a postpaid customer. So, if you go to
when you say CIS, what does that mean?
That's your account. You know, we have prepaid customers. That's you're expected to have a prepaid number. That's your meter number.
Right.
Okay. If you are not a prepaid customer, it means that you are a postpaid customer. So that number, that account number, is what I'm referring to as customer CIS number.
Okay.
So that's the number that you also have to. So you have to provide all of the information that will enable whoever it is that is collating to be able to help. Because most times, even when we hold our virtual stakeholders engagement, we emphasize the need for customers to put all of the information that we would need. So once again, it's called IE Serve. Just IE Serve. That means Ikeja Electric Serve.
Okay.
At Ikeja Electric Serve. You see, of course, all of the Ikeja Electric information there, where we wrote customer first technology now. And so you can drop all of you. And this site has always been updated. You can also get information. And on the same X, you can also go to at Ikeja Electric, where you see updated information on Ikeja Electric.
Let's look at other scenarios now. So I want to move into a building and I want to get information about the meter of that particular building. If I get there, are there ways I can do that by myself?
Yes, you can. Okay, so you want to move into a new apartment and you want to find out whether there's an outstanding there, or whether somebody who has previously lived there has been penalized and there's something called a loss of revenue that has been factored onto the meter. You can also, at the comfort of your home, send an email, put all the details that you need. If it's a prepaid account, you write it there. If it's a postpaid, put all the details, address, all of the information needed, and ask that you get an attachment showing you the history of that account, whether prepaid or postpaid in this case, so that you know whether there's an outstanding there and you can quickly take that up with the owner of the property or the realtor, whoever it is that you're liaising with. So,
okay. Yes, so that can be done easily.
Absolutely. And also, it's important for customers to know that if you're moving into or if you just got a meter newly installed, okay? So for some customers, they have newly installed meter and then maybe the meter was installed in January. So you now by April or May, you want to vend and you see that, okay, they've made an amount due. This is also a frequent kind of complaint that we get.
Mm.
Okay, so they made an amount due and you see that you're not able to vend. And just last week, Victor, somebody in the industry, one of your colleagues, called to say, they have made 200,000 naira due on his meter and he's not able to vend. Mm. So it's important for customers to know that when you have a new meter, remember that prior to getting that meter, you were a postpaid customer.
Right.
So whatever bill
that you are owing
exactly would have been factored
into that meter.
That's one. Also, remember that the meter came to you with a preloaded unit. Okay. Usually 100 or above 100 units. Okay. The value of that has also been factored. So it means that you're also going to pay for that.
Why is that 100 units there? Okay. It's a new meter.
Yeah, so it's a new meter. No, you know, because they can't just give you a new meter empty. There has to be unit on it. You have to be able to use it.
Okay.
You understand? So just to enable you start using it.
Oh.
And
you've not paid for it.
No, you've not paid for it at that time. So it's more like you're going to pay for it like a postpaid customer you have used it. You have to use it first and then before you now go ahead and vend. Oh. So, and then for other customers, they also have outstanding, even aside from the previous month that they had used the electricity. So all of these will be factored into it.
Right.
And it is expected that as the months go by,
mm-hmm.
you are vending monthly. Monthly, this is very important. You are vending. I'll tell you why it is important for you to be vending monthly, so that you are defraying the debt as you're using the meter. So what happens is that this customer in question, he got the meter installed, I think, in January.
Okay.
And so he didn't vend. He probably didn't, for some reasons, he didn't exhaust whatever it is that came, the preloaded unit. Yes, he didn't exhaust it. So it was until May. And as at May, he now was asking, why is 200,000 naira made due on this meter? So it is expected that that outstanding that you have had
mm-hmm.
every month, if the agreement is that you'll be paying, say, 40,000 naira.
Right.
And you month one, you didn't pay. It rolled over to month two. So by month two, it would have been 80. By month three, it would have been 120. You get my point?
Right.
So it would just be accumulating like that. So it's like a loan that you have not been paying. And of course, it's piling up. So
Yeah, but I'm curious at that point. Why is that information not shared with the owner of the meter?
It is, because here is it. Before that debt repayment is being spread on your meter,
mm-hmm.
there's some kind of engagement at that point. So you would have been told that, okay, so you have maybe 150,000 naira
right.
outstanding. They would have told you that every month you're expected to be paying X amount aside from the value of the energy that you're going to be using. So, for instance, if every month you're expected to be paying 40,000 naira,
right.
you're expected to vend above 40,000 naira. So that 40,000 naira will be used.
Deducted.
Yes. And then whatever is left will now be for your energy, the value of the energy token that you're going to use.
Mm.
So at that point, that has been done. So, but what customers, a lot of customers, that most times they would have forgotten that, okay, since I haven't exhausted it, I mean, they don't see a need to vend. I mean, naturally so,
right.
because you still have something using.
Did this colleague of mine, did he know about this?
He said he didn't know, but I'll be shocked, because that would be an unusual thing, because at the point of getting the meter, all of those engagements would have taken place, because okay. that's standard practice. So I told him that, okay, this is why this has happened. And so from time to time, anytime you're getting a meter, don't forget that you have an outstanding. Even if you don't have an outstanding as at the time of getting the meter, don't forget that you were a postpaid customer prior to the installation of that meter. So what that means is that if he came in January 4th, remember that as at December, you were still a postpaid customer. So that December 1 to 31st to December 3rd, you were using electricity until that day that meter was installed.
All right, Halima, let's talk about how best to preserve a meter. You know, a lot of times when some people get these meters, maybe in 6 months, 7 months, something goes wrong, it goes bad, and replacement now becomes a challenge.
Yeah.
So how can I preserve my meter to ensure that it lasts?
Okay, so this is why it is important that that's why there's a survey before the point of before installation. So the essence of the survey is to be able to advise the customer on the appropriate meter, on the meter suitable based on the load of the customer. Okay, so at that point, you're advised to say buy a single phase or a three phase, depending on the, your load, your usage, whatever it is that you're drawing. And so for that, you're advised to buy this type of meter. Now, but then for some customers, it's either they don't stick to the advice that they have been given, or they feel like, okay, they're knowledgeable enough, and then they go ahead and even sometimes buy a three-phase meter. And guess what? Sometimes, Victor, if you have a load that your prepaid meter cannot carry, it will definitely go bad. You will definitely have a case of a burnt meter. And at that point, if the reason for, even if your meter is still under warranty, okay, and the reason for your meter going bad is as a result of the fault of the customer, in this case, the customer's load, then the customer will be liable for replacement. It is only when your meter is still within the warranty period, and the fault is actually maybe as a result of any other fault, maybe factory fault or some other reasons, and that is when the business will now, of course, revert to the vendors to ask for a replacement or a repair, as the case may demand. So that's exactly the way it is. So for preserving the life of your meter,
right,
of course, you do not call in. And if you have any fault, say your meter is not supplying the house, okay?
Mm-hmm.
It is not for you to call a quack on the street. It's for
so let's
you
talk about that. So who do I call?
So it's for you to escalate to Ikeja Electric. So you can either put a call through, you send an email, or walk into any of the offices closer.
Some people have complained that by the time you do that, it could take like 1 week before your people will respond.
Well, no, that's not exactly the case, Victor.
Okay.
While it is also true that sometimes we have a lot of people who are on what we call on our dashboard who have escalated, okay, we try as much as possible to close out within the shortest time possible, but not as long as 7 days, keeping the customer out of supply, because of course we know the implication of that. Some customers have said that they are tempted to call maybe people on their street or call unlicensed technicians who are not employees of Ikeja Electric to do that. But that's a dangerous thing to do.
Mm.
And we do not advise customers to do that.
Right.
So you have to come to Ikeja Electric or send an email or call all of the channels available to you. Please do well to use it. Now, when you're on your street and you have a fault on your transformer or your meter or whatever it is, and maybe you see people in their in the van driving past your street and you call them, you have not lodged a complaint. If you call me as your friend, you have not lodged a complaint. Yes. If Victor says, my house is out of supply, I'm calling Halima's number. You haven't lodged a complaint, Victor.
So I have to lodge it formally.
You have to. The only way you can now talk to me is after you have generated an SR. You say, oh, please, I have an SR here. Can you just help me check if what the status is? Oh, yes, I can. I can now say, okay, you have done the right thing. But if you just call me to tell me because I'm your friend, I will still ask you to go call customer care or lodge the complaint. And I wouldn't expect that you get offended, because that's the process.
All right, then Lagos Traffic Radio, 96.1 FM, Ikeja Electric, and you. I have Halima Shuaibu, who is the External Communications Coordinator for Ikeja Electric. And we are trying to bridge the knowledge gap for you as a consumer under Ikeja Electric. We're going to take a short break right now. When we return, whistleblowing. How can that help out in terms of electricity distribution? And we'll also hear from you as well. 080-99-120-777.
My brother, what is the problem with these NEPA people? They have disconnected my light again. There's nothing like NEPA again. It's Ikeja Electric. Did you connect illegally?
I only called one electrician nearby to connect it for me.
What? You and that electrician are joking with 21 years imprisonment. It's illegal to connect or reconnect yourself or carry out any form of activity on Ikeja Electric network. Doing so will not only cause damage, it can lead to electric shock and electrocution.
21 years imprisonment? Electrocution? God forbid. Please, I'm going to contact Ikeja Electric. Electric right now for proper connection to stay alive peacefully with my family.
If you want to connect or reconnect light, kindly contact Ikeja Electric's nearest office to you and also report any energy theft you notice around you through Ikeja Electric's customer care numbers 01-488-3900, 01-7000-250 and 0700-022-5543 or send an email to customercare@ikejaelectric.com. Ikeja Electric, bringing energy to life.
Hey, have you heard the good news about Ikeja Electric?
What is new this time?
Ikeja Electric has made payment of electricity bills a lot easier through multiple payment channels accessible anywhere, anytime. You can pay using bank mobile apps and websites, Ikeja Electric website, and through their payment agents as well. The payment channels are convenient, reliable, and secure.
Fantastic!
Please pay your bill to avoid disconnection and ensure you collect or print your receipt as evidence of payment. Do not give cash to any Ikeja Electric staff for bill settlement, reconnection fee, meter bypass, or any of the surcharges. For more information, visit www.ikejaelectric.com. You can also contact customer care on 01-700-250 and 01-2272-940 or send an email to customercare@ikejaelectric.com. Ikeja Electric, bringing energy to life.
Lagos Traffic Radio, 96.1 FM. Ikeja Electric and You is the program. And I see her with me, Halima Shuaibu. And of course, we are dealing or trying to see how we put you through the right path as it relates to your relationship with Ikeja Electric. Most of the areas we're covering is still looking good. And of course, if you're making that journey to the island, you still have it good on the Third Milan Bridge. Ikorodu Road as well is faring well as you drive along this beautiful Monday morning. All right, then let's see if we can expand the scope beyond the studios to have your input as well. 08099120777. That's 08099120777. Limited time on the program, so once you get through, please go straight to your question or perhaps your contribution.
Good morning.
All right, good morning.
My name is Adigunga from Kushofe in my
church. Adigunga from Kushofe, go ahead.
Yeah, what I just, I mean, concerning what the IKDC official just mentioned about the meter. You see, we bought our meter, maybe let me say 10 generation prepaid. And now the meter, they say they're bigger than 10. So the meter now has been outdated. They say we should come and buy another one. Unfortunately, in their office there, they say we don't have the meter. And now we are finding it difficult to know this, our meter. And the meter is not available in their office. What do we do? That is number one. Number two, concerning this, QOCs, KKBA, and they say they are subsidizing. I don't think they are subsidizing anything. Because there are some private companies that are giving us letter on these things. They are private. Are they subsidizing? Who is subsidizing who? Thank you, my brother.
All right.
The other part of the question is not clear, Mr. Adegbenga. You're saying that private companies are subsidizing electricity? Or as he's gone?
Okay, he's gone.
Okay, the other part is not too clear. Right. Are you able to make a sense out of it?
Right. Well, just go ahead with the first part now. All right. Maybe you need to respond to that.
So he is saying that he has an outdated meter. Yes, because the technology that we have right now is not supporting those kind of meters, like he rightfully said. And of course, long ago we've been engaging customers, asking them to get new meters, of course the ones that are regarded as smart meters, and of course we've been supported by the current technology. So yes, but unfortunately, like he said the meters are not available. Meters are available, like we've been saying, Victor. However, we've also been saying that due to the issue of Forex, the vendors, who are people who refer to as the MAP, meter asset providers, have said that it's not exactly profitable for them to sell the meters as it is right now until all of that issues regarding pricing and Forex is...
So what would you advise him to do?
So he should go to the office. He actually should go to the office and speak to the commercial manager. I don't know where he said he's calling from Kushofe. So that's he should be under Anthony. it should be under Anthony
Business Unit.
Yes, no, and Anthony Undertaking Office. Yes, this one, the Anthony office is on along Lugbon Street. He can go there and speak to either the Undertaking Manager. He should ask to speak to Mr. Benga, and then he should discuss this. This can be worked out because he cannot have an outdated meter that he's not able to load. It means that he's not able to use electricity. So he should seek Benga, and then that will be resolved. Apologies for that, but this is also a very good medium to talk to customers to say, when we engage you on certain things, it's because we don't want you to run into trouble like this.
Right. Let's begin to take this call. Yeah. Hello there, good morning. Hello. Hello, can you hear me? Okay, that's a dropped call. The moment you get through, please try and turn down the volume of your radio, perhaps. If you're having any form of disturbances, just move away from where that is so we can have a good conversation. 08099-120-777. Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
And what's your name?
How are you?
Very good.
My name is Babatunde. I'm speaking from Egbeda.
Nice to hear from you, sir.
I like the tone of Auntie Alima. She's speaking both as a PR person and a marketer. Unfortunately, situation is not the same at their side there. I have two incidences.
Okay.
First, it started in 2022. I had a complaint which I took to the office at Akowojo.
Okay.
By the time the thing stayed for a long time, I had to report to Lagos State Consumer Protection Agency, and they invited us because they said IKEG comes there every time. We went there, met the officer, and she sorted the things out, and they said they will contact me. Up till now, no contact. Number two, on the 8th of September, 8th of November 2022, they changed my meter to a new one. The old one had some energy, which is on it, about 200 and something, and they said they would change it. I went there first. Well, after they did not, they gave me an SR. After I got that again and cut back, nothing happened. Up till now, they gave me two SR, and nothing has happened on it. They just said, you have noticed what you have sent. We'll send it to appropriate quarters. Second time, we have noticed we are going to do something. Since 2022, nothing has happened up till now.
Wow.
So that's why I said at times it's easier saying now, but by the time they get to the office, it's a different ballgame entirely. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, Babatunde, for that. Alima, okay. So SRL, since 2022, this is 2024. Not yet resolved.
Okay, so he's talking about the token reissuance. Not exactly token, but more like a transfer of the whatever was left in the old meter to the new one, and he hasn't got that. Okay, so I would urge him, if he could still send this SR, so I could even check that for him. I wish he had stayed on this line. Call here, so that we could just close out on that. Apologies for that. Also, the other part is that he had complained in Akonwojo to Las Copa. He has an SR. Both of them, since he has an SR, we can escalate all of these, and so that we can close out on this.
Okay, so what we'll do, we'll try and get his number for you.
Yes, please, his number, so that I can reach out to him. Or he can collate, put the two SR, because he seemed to have...
Hello?
All right, let's just take this last call. Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
All right, what's your name?
This is Pastor Thomas.
Pastor Thomas, can I get your contribution in 45 seconds?
I have a complaint.
Okay, go ahead.
I changed my prepaid meter from the old type to the new one. And I have some credit on the old one, over 300 and something. So to transfer it to the new one, they are making it difficult. My wife has gone to Ikeja Electric and allows her to complain. They refer her to that's a better area here. That's where we live.
Okay.
Do you have the SR number, sir?
Came and
Mr. Thomas, can you share the SR number, sir?
Away, and up till now, nothing has been done. So what do I do?
Okay, do you have the SR? Do you have the SR number, sir?
Unit on the old meter.
Okay, Pastor Thomas, just a second. Do you have the SR number?
SR number? What? Yes, I have. The new one or the old one?
You can give me the most recent.
The new one.
Okay. They are not with me right away.
Okay, but you can send it to this number even after the program. That will be collated.
We'll get your number as well, okay?
I didn't get you.
We will get your number so we can reach you after the program.
Okay. No problem.
All right. Thank you so much. And that will be the last call because of time constraints, really. But even as we head off, whistleblowing is very, very essential. There are people that are doing illegal things under the distribution company. Mm. So what do we do in this kind of situation?
Yes, we get reports that people are asking for money. And of course, you know, we even on our jingle, we talk about extortion. And for people to get help, they should send an email to... And it's important to know that you'll be anonymous. Your identity will be protected. Even when you send an email, we don't see the sender's email. So send an email to expressyourself@ikejaelectric.com. I'll take that slowly. expressyourself@ikejaelectric.com. It's also important to call. We have a toll-free number you can call. That means you're not paying to call that number. But please, it's important to know that this is not a complaint, a customer complaint channel. Mm. It is for whistleblowing. And the number to call is 0800-847-6337. I'll take that again. 0800-847-6337. 6337.
We'll leave it at that for now because of time. Thank we have to go. Halima, thank you so much for being here.
It's a pleasure. Thank you, Victor.
Okay, so next Monday, you can always catch up with us on Ikeja Electric and you by 9:15. And of course, we'll be here to answer your complaints. We have to go. The program was produced by Mike James. I say a big thank you to Afe John and also to Okpemi Shodunke. Tayo Akonle is our executive producer. My name is